the last time you were on the chair, you were here with Roger. Yeah. You and Roger had done the interview with this, yeah. And Roger's not obviously going to be here for this. What's that experience been like?
That's been unbelievable. You know, Roger and I were friends for more than 50 years, and we worked together for more than 40. And we were, you know, buddies and really, really close partners.
When Roger was sick with leukemia, you were the only cast member who knew, right?
Yes, yeah, yeah.
That's quite a thing to carry around together.
Yeah, yeah. No, well, I guess because we'd known each other so well and for so long. He was diagnosed in 1997, and really his sister knew and his niece knew and I knew, and that was pretty much it for maybe 10 years. And then very gradually, as his condition began to deteriorate a little bit, he let other people in on it. But even, I would say, when Roger died in March, perhaps only 10 people knew that he was sick. Maybe a dozen.
Wow.
Tops. So that's why it was such a shock to everybody when it happened. I mean, I remember being in the office on Sunday when we let the news out. He died on Saturday night. And it was like there was this tidal wave of interest. I mean, the phone ringing, the emails. I think I had over 600 emails in less than 24 hours.
It speaks to what Roger was able to accomplish as a performer, but also what you guys did as a family. Yeah, in a way, yeah. Over the
years.
You
know, I don't want. This sounds all very somber, this conversation, but we had a lot of fun. You know, we had 40 fabulous years, and I don't just mean Roger and I, but I mean the Air Farce as a group, because you can't do comedy unless you're enjoying it. It's like if you're mad or angry, and to do comedy is really difficult, especially with other people. So we always made sure that whatever happened in the daytime, we ended the day as friends.
Yeah.
And we spent so much time touring, radio,
when
TV,
when I was reading this
stage.
Book, dude, though, what I really liked about this Air Farce book, too, is that you do talk about all the good times and the great experiences, but it doesn't hide the fact that there was some stuff behind the scenes, like Dave Rodrick practically quit because of Luba being late.
That's right.
And the tension with you guys, like, it's real. It's so that,
No. Well, I thought, you
has
know.
Has Luba read the book?
Yes, but she has, yes, but she's fine with it. Yeah,
okay.
Yeah, because this is not like a secret that I was letting out of the bag for the first time. We're friendly enough and we're real enough to know that we can talk about these things.
Right.
But it was just an extraordinary experience recreating it. It was really a privilege in a sense because I had to carry on alone after Roger died. We submitted the first bit of it to the publisher and then he was gone. And it was really a great privilege to be able to spend the summer looking back over all the years that we had together, you know, and you go back and look when you're young and how much fun you had and how crazy it was, and you're thinking, this is never going to last. Let's go for it while we can, you know. Then you find yourself 40 years later thinking, I'm still doing it.